Macmillan Audio presents Nutrition Zombies, 10 Nutrition Myths That Refuse to Die by Monica Reinagel. Read for you by the author.
Introduction. People often tell me that they find the whole business of eating healthy overwhelming. There's too many rules, too much conflicting information, too many things to pay attention to and worry about. And I can certainly understand why. We're constantly being inundated with diet and nutrition-related information, from the morning news shows to the overstuffed magazine rack at the gym to those alarming emails your Aunt Shirley keeps forwarding you. Every day, there's a new research study, a new hazard lurking in the fridge, or a complete reversal of last month's marching orders. One way to simplify the healthy eating prescription is to stop worrying about things that don't really matter. In the following pages, I debunk 10 of the most widespread and oft-repeated myths about nutrition. Some of these myths are harmless enough. Others are time and energy-wasting distractions. A few are downright bad advice. My hope is that clearing away outdated and misguided notions about nutrition will allow you to focus on the things that really do make a difference, and I've pointed these out along the way as well. Even better, perhaps having 10 fewer things to worry about will make it easier to enjoy just how fun and pleasurable healthy eating can be. I realize that a lot of what I have to say here runs contrary to things you've heard in the past, and part of what I'm trying to do is encourage a healthy skepticism about the information you come across, so it would be hypocritical of me to ask you to accept everything I say at face value. But as I think you'll see, I take my myth-busting pretty seriously. That means actually running down the research rather than simply repeating the conventional wisdom. If you're the type that likes to poke around under the hood, you'll find a list of the studies and sources I consulted on the book's webpage at www.quickanddirtytips.com/ndebooks. Myth number one, caffeine is bad for you. Ever notice that smug look people get when they tell you they don't do caffeine? Well, I'm here to tell you, there's no need to feel sheepish about enjoying coffee or tea. In fact, the caffeinated may have the last laugh. Both coffee and caffeine have a lot of positive health benefits, and many of the harmful effects attributed to caffeine are actually myths. Here are some of the most common ones. Myth number one, coffee or caffeine increases breast pain or tenderness, or causes benign breast lumps, or even increases your risk for breast cancer. Some women who have breast pain or tenderness swear that their symptoms improve when they stop drinking coffee or caffeine. But research shows that breast pain is just as likely to disappear when women continue drinking coffee as when they give it up. Similarly, extensive clinical research has found no link between coffee and breast cancer or benign breast lumps. Myth number two, caffeine weakens your bones. It is true that when you take in more caffeine, you tend to lose more calcium in your urine. But you needn't worry that this robs your bones of needed calcium. Your body compensates for these losses by increasing the amount of calcium that it absorbs from the foods you eat. As long as your diet contains enough calcium and other bone-building minerals, coffee consumption has little to no long-term effect on your bone health or your osteoporosis risk. Myth number three, drinking coffee wears out your adrenal gland. It is true that caffeine stimulates the production of cortisol by the adrenal glands. The rise in cortisol is usually mild, temporary, and harmless. However, this effect can be exaggerated in people who are under a lot of stress. Having a lot of cortisol coursing through your body all the time doesn't feel good, and it isn't particularly good for you either. If you're under extraordinary stress, cutting out caffeine may help mitigate the damage, but finding effective ways to reduce or manage your stress will help even more. Rest assured, however, that neither sustained stress nor coffee consumption will cause your adrenal gland to stop functioning. Myth number four, caffeine or coffee is bad for your heart. Some studies have found that drinking unfiltered coffee, such as French press or percolated coffee, elevates cholesterol. It appears to be the volatile oils in the coffee rather than the caffeine that affect cholesterol, and only in men. However, coffee drinkers are no more likely to develop heart disease than non-coffee drinkers. Caffeine also temporarily elevates your blood pressure, but does not raise your risk of having a stroke. In fact, coffee consumption appears to slightly reduce your risk of a stroke. Similarly, caffeine temporarily increases your heart rate, but does not cause arrhythmia. As it turns out, the bad news about caffeine isn't really so bad. So now let's take a look at the good news. Benefit number one, caffeine boosts mental performance. Caffeine doesn't make you any smarter, but it does make you more alert.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.